Good morning. Thanks for tuning in. Well, the local share market's going to kick off with a modest decline this morning. The futures are telling us the ASX 200 will be down by less than a quarter of a percent. So eating into yesterday's effort where we saw the index up by around 0.4%. But I suppose the encouraging aspect of what we'll see this morning, and indeed what we saw a little bit of yesterday, is that the market is showing some signs of stabilization or consolidation after the steep sell-off of the previous three sessions, where we've seen the index fall by as much as 6%. So perhaps more encouraging was the performance that we saw on Wall Street last night. It wasn't just a matter of consolidation, which found its roots yesterday. It is the fact that you've seen some accelerated buying off the lows of recent sessions. In fact, after the market rose by 0.8%, where the Dow was concerned last night, the S&P 500 and the NASDAQ each improved by about a percent. You've seen the S&P 500, for example, from the lows of the last day, rallied by the better part of 4%. So that's important in the context of, you know, some of these grim statistics that we've been reciting in recent days. You know, for example, the previous session in the US was the worst in about 2 years for the S&P 500. So to see that emphatic buying from these lows is good news, but we really need to see a couple more days of trade before we can perhaps breathe a little more easily under the circumstances. But given that, it's important to see the way that safe haven trades are behaving. So even though you've seen a better tone in equity markets in the last day, if, for example, there's still money moving into safe havens at a rapid clip, you'd just be a little more wary. So the good news is that safe havens actually fell last night. So the US dollar index was down pretty steady last night, but over the course of the last 3 days, it has fallen by about 1.5%. So if things were acutely under pressure, you would see money moving into the US dollar at a pretty substantial clip. You'd say the same for gold, but gold prices actually moderated over the course of the last day. They were down by about a percent, so around 2387 US dollars per ounce. They've fallen by as much as 5% over the course of the last couple of days. So again, if you were worried about a systemic event or perhaps something that was going to be a little more long-tailed, then gold prices would be a lot better bid than what they are at the moment. What we also look at is what happens with bond yields, because if bond yields are moving aggressively lower under these circumstances, that's another example that investors are trying to find a safe haven whilst and get some cover from the volatility in other markets. And it's not often that you talk about a rise in bond yields in favorable terms, but last night we had a two-year government bond up by 9 basis points to 3.98. 10-year was up by 11 basis points to 3.89%. Of course, much of this would not have happened had we not seen some stability emerge where the Japanese equity market was concerned last night. So yesterday we had the Nikkei up by about 10%. It's a recovery from the 20% fall that we saw in the previous day. The Japanese equity market over the course of the last month, however, has lost the better part of 30%. The point to make here is that when you see that kind of rapid readjustment, it makes you very wary about second and third order consequences that could see the failure of some important parts in the financial system. And that's why we need some time to be able to see whether or not that stress has actually emerged. So that's why it's important not to be too glib and say that we're out of the woods where this volatility is concerned, when we have seen such extreme price moves in other areas. So just to quickly highlight what we saw on Wall Street at a higher level, and worth pointing out that all of the 11 sectors that make up the S&P 500 in broad groups were higher. Real estate stocks were the most improved, up by about 2%. Simon Property, this is a company that is the largest largest operator of shopping malls in the United States. They also have one of the largest REITs in the United States. When you see these types of circumstances, property stocks can often be the first port of call in terms of selling. And the day before, this company was down by 5%. It rose by 5% last night. Communication stocks did quite well last night. So Meta, Netflix, Disney, they were all up in the order of around 2 to 4%. Financial stocks also stood out with an improvement. They were amongst the most improved in the S&P sectors. JP Morgan, Bank Corp, Goldman Sachs, they were all up by more than 2%. The KBW Bank Index was up by 1.2% as well. Consumer discretionary stocks did quite well. Caribbean cruises last night were up by about 7%. We also saw some better than expected earnings, including Caterpillar, up by 3%. So that helped the industrial stocks to a nice gain. And Uber was a contributor to the gains where the tech names are concerned. They delivered better than expected earnings. And that stock was up by about 11%. So that is important to just understand, because it means investors are focusing on the fundamentals rather than just throwing the baby out with the bathwater, as was the case a little bit in days prior. So today, as I said, we'll kick off just in negative territory, and just important to watch how the market plays out. Of course, we had the RBA conclude its policy setting meeting, and probably what's changed a little bit in the last day is people's perceptions around what's going to happen with interest rates. The recognition of underlying inflation being elevated was reflected in the RBA governor's comments. The belief now in the markets that we're unlikely to see a rate move until the early part of next year, that, you know, higher for longer is the mantra for the moment, at least, is perhaps a part of why the ASX 200 is a little bit under pressure today relative to the improvements that we've seen in the Northern Hemisphere. The Aussie dollar has also been able to consolidate because of that RBA commentary. So it has been under a lot of pressure in recent days. As you might imagine, it's been as low as 63.5 US cents. But as we record this morning, it's trading closer to 65.2 US cents. There's not much on offer today in terms of corporate or economic news. There'll be a couple of RBA officials commenting in front of the Senate Select Committee in Canberra today. Whether or not that gives rise to any comments that are valuable at the moment, that's another question. But have a good day, and I'll talk to you again tomorrow.